This is Jodi from Joderson Art, and welcome back to another collaboration. Today, I am going to be working on a convex canvas. This is a 20-inch canvas, and this is by Frederick's. And you have to special order this, and they're pretty expensive. So I try to really have a plan when I'm using one of these because we don't want to waste it. So I just put down that Walmart Color Place paint, and I'm just going to spread it around a little bit. And I'm going to start putting my colors down. My first color I have here is the Colourarte Bling It Indigo. Yay, great color. It's a good base color too. Here I'm going for some pastels since it's spring. I don't do a lot of pastels. If you've ever seen any of my other work, it's usually red and gold. So this is a little different, but it's fun. Up next, this is the Watermelon Mist by Colourarte, another beautiful color. Now we have Colourarte Sky Blue. And as you see, I'm just laying these down in one straight line. And I'm going to show you what I'm going to do with it in just a few minutes. Because this is going to be an embellished piece. So just stay with me for a little bit. You'll see where this is going. Up next, we have the Colourarte Love You Pink. I was pretty disappointed after I mixed this up because I realized it was the last of my bottle. So I'm going to have to reach out to Colourarte and ask them to send me some more. This is a great light pink color. Most of the lighter pinks I've worked with have faded into the painting, and this pink can definitely hold its own. Up next, we have the Grünbacher Turquoise. And that had thickened up a little bit on me, so I just added a little bit more of the Liquitex Gloss Varnish. Because I mix my paints 50-50, so I can add a little varnish to it if it just gets a little bit thick. Up next, we have Golden. This is the Neon Pink. And if you want some color in your painting, just throw this down, but don't overdose on it because you'll end up with just a super bright pink painting. And up next, we have Colourarte Interference Gold. You guys knew I couldn't do a painting without Interference Gold. This is my favorite color by Colourarte. And last, I'm going to be adding another one of my favorites. It's called Mango Freeze. Such a pretty color. It's like a gold mango color together. One of my favorite by far. And now we're going to get to some swiping. So I'm using Australian Floetrol in Golden Carbon Black in a ratio of 4:1. And I'm going to do a series of small swipes so when I tilt this off, it doesn't have one straight edge on it. And you'll see, we're getting close. Okay, so here I'm just finishing up, just touching up a little bit. And next what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring this to my spinner. I'm gonna open up some of those cells and I'm gonna tilt some of this paint off. And here we go. Here we are at the spinner. And I'm just gonna give this a good spin and just open some of those cells up. And now I decide which direction I want it to go. And I'm just gonna start tilting all of that paint off. We have some really super nice cells and some great colors going on here. Very pastel-y, very spring-like, and that's what I was going for. Because I'm going to make some butterflies next. So I didn't want that straight edge. I'm happy with the way the composition of the paint as it's coming off. And you want to make sure you don't leave a lot of paint. Okay, so up next, what I'm doing here is I'm gonna make some paint skins, guys, so that I can make some butterflies to put on the convex canvas that we just saw. So just in case you don't know how to do paint skins, what I'm doing is I'm just taking the colors that I just used. As you see, I'm being a little less careful and just kind of putting them down. And that's a nice piece of silicone that I bought off of Amazon, and I just put a regular painting that I didn't like underneath of it and put it right on the spinner. And just layered those colors up in the same order, or pretty much kind of the same order. It doesn't really matter. And I'm just gonna do some quick swipes through here. And now this one I'm gonna spin pretty hard, and the reason is because when you're doing skins, you want them to be pretty thin. And this goes with jewelry too. I don't know if any of you have ever tried making jewelry. If your paint skins are too thick, it's just gonna pop the glass out. So I just try to get it as thin as I can. And sometimes you lose some of it, but that's okay. So I'm looking at this and I think I have some good stuff on here. I'm gonna go let both of these dry. And we're back. So as you can see, that's how easy it is to take it off. See how very nice and thin it is? It's gonna make it really easy for me to cut off some of the embellishments. So here we go. I have a butterfly. It's a plastic, it's supposed to be for alcohol inks, but I used it to use it to trace. So initially what I did is I took a pen and I kind of just outlined it, but it wasn't really working that great for me. The paint skins were moving. I was having a little bit of a hard time. And don't forget, guys, go to colourarte.com to fill out your submission. So you see, I did get that one butterfly there, and now we're gonna do another one. I have an X-Acto knife. Be careful, don't cut your finger off. Here we go. You can just pick whatever part of the skin that you like. just cut it out, and you don't have to make butterflies. You can make anything you want. This is really good for people like myself who are not good at realism, and it's just fun. So I noticed on this one I have something white on there. I have no idea what it is, and I can't use it. So back to the drawing board. And you might want to take notice. Okay, now that I have my embellishments done, I'm going to take my dried painting, and I'm just using regular old school Elmer's glue. Just attaching it, putting it where you like, just like that. And then I decide I want two little tiny butterflies on there, and I don't have paint skins, so I am going to use just two little small temporary tattoos, which actually I've used these before and they hold up very well under resin, so this painting definitely has to get resined, and I was going to resin it anyway, so it really popped. Guys, that's it, and it's a lot of fun, and I had a lot of fun today, and I hope you guys have fun too. I hope everyone learned something.